Hey everyone, this is Mr. Dunkel. Today we're going to be talking about Lewis and Clark and their expedition across the Louisiana Territory and the rest of what will later become our country. And we talked briefly about this the last time that you were in class when we discussed the Louisiana Purchase that Thomas Jefferson did, where he doubled the size of the country. And so we're going to focus a little more on now the two guys and their crew that are going to go explore this new territory that we have. Now, as you see here, the opener, we've got a picture of a movie called Almost Heroes, and it's not a great movie, but it's pretty silly. If you ever have some free time on your hands and want to watch something silly, this is definitely a choice for you. Almost Heroes is dealing with two guys who are trying to race Lewis and Clark and be the first ones to make it all the way there. And they don't quite make it. They're almost heroes, where Lewis and Clark truly are heroes. But again, it's set in the same time period and kind of taking a very funny look at maybe some of the things Lewis and Clark may have experienced as they went on their way. So something to keep in mind if you have a break and want to watch something. Now, Lewis and Clark, they're going to do their expedition 1804 to 1806, as you see there. And you see our standard, our Tennessee State standard at the bottom. And what we're really going to focus on is just kind of recognizing the route that they took, as well as reading some things from their journals and what did they actually encounter along the way. So let's go ahead and get started with what we have. When you look at this map here, it does a really good job of showing you the Louisiana Purchase, the United States, you know, what was officially the United States at that time under Thomas Jefferson, is this area over here, which is in orange, over on the eastern side. And then in the center that you see in green, that's Louisiana Purchase, which Thomas Jefferson bought from Napoleon. And if you recall when we discussed that, France was in a war with England at the time. Napoleon was leading France. Even though the French controlled this area in the Americas, they really weren't profiting, making a whole lot of money from it. And Napoleon realized, you know, he'd really just rather have the money for it as opposed to trying to keep up with that and fight a war in Europe too. So he sells the Louisiana Territory to the United States for an incredibly cheap price, $15 million roughly, for all of that. And it's just an amazing deal. It doubled the size of our country. But we talked about, when we were talking about Thomas Jefferson's presidency, one of the negatives with that is Thomas Jefferson didn't get approval from Congress to go make this huge purchase. And Thomas Jefferson was a man who kind of promoted himself as being against big government, thought states should have the power and, you know, government shouldn't be doing all these big decisions, yet he goes out and does a huge decision. But it was almost one that was, you couldn't pass up. It was, you know, when you go to a store and there's a sale and it's just too good of a sale, you just gotta buy it. That's basically what he did here. And as you can see on this map, doubles the size of our country. So what leads to later is we're then going to compete for the Spanish territory, which we are able to get later, and then our country goes from sea to shining sea. So let's get in and discuss a little bit more about Lewis and Clark. It's, as you see here, America's most famous expedition. It's, you know, two guys and their crew that are going into uncharted land. And so this is an area, what they're trying to hopefully find is a river that they can take all the way across to the Pacific Ocean. Because if you can have a river that goes all the way through like that, it's going to make transportation easier. You can build cities along the river. Next year, in your freshman year, when you start talking about Industrial Revolution, you'll realize, you know, even more importance of rivers for factories being built on them, for water power and things of that nature. But what happens here is Lewis and Clark are hired by Thomas Jefferson. And what he wants them to do is to go out through that territory and figure out what's there, what Native American tribes are there, are they friendly, are there resources that we could be using that we could, you know, use to manufacture things or to sell things, and again, hopefully to find a good, easy route all the way across to the Pacific Ocean. Now, looking at this map, you'll kind of see what the route that they took. The yellow is indicating the outward journey, so when they left, and then the orange or red is referring to the homeward journey. And you'll notice there's a part where Lewis and Clark have different dots or dashes. Lewis, for instance, has kind of some bigger dashes, and Clark has some smaller ones. And that's a part where they split up for a little while and to kind of go a couple of different routes to see which one might be the better route. But if you'll notice in the bottom right area, that St. Louis is kind of going to be where they, not kind of, is where they take off from. St. Louis, as you notice here, you have the Missouri River and the Mississippi River joining together. So they were familiar with the Mississippi, very much so, because the Mississippi kind of made the border of the United States. You'll see here's Tennessee, just barely sticking in on this map, and Memphis is on the Mississippi. So St. Louis is kind of their starting point, and that's where the Missouri takes off and heads westward. So they follow along the Missouri as much as they can, but they do get to a point as you get a little past Great Falls and Yellowstone, some things like that, where the Missouri ends. And there's also Yellowstone River there as well. And they just can't take any more by boat, so they have to get off and travel over the Rocky Mountains. And then they finally get back onto another river and are able to take the Columbia River all the way to the Pacific Ocean. So we'll do an activity a little bit later today where you're going to have a chance to kind of follow that route, so you'll get to see it a little bit more. But it was really quite a long journey. It takes them a little bit over 2 years to do the journey. And again, kind of a dangerous journey too, because they're going into uncharted area. They're dealing with Native Americans who aren't always friendly to the white people, and for good reason, because the white settlers had not always been friendly to them. So it took a lot of bravery to do what they did. Now, some of the dangers that they ran into, obviously there's just natural dangers. You know, you could fall off a cliff or get swept away, you know, in a river or things of that nature. So there's this tremendous wilderness that they're having to cross. You're also dealing with wild animals, be it bear or wolves or whatever else you might come across out in the woods. And as we just talked about, there's also a lot of, you know, Native American tribes that are they're encountering. So to help with this, they had some Native American guides who traveled with them. And probably the most famous is a woman by the name of Sacagawea. And she was actually pregnant and had a child. And she had a child that traveled with her during this journey. And Sacagawea was hugely important because when they met other tribes, she was able to either speak the language, if she could, and communicate that, you know, we're peaceful, we don't mean any harm, we're just passing through, and so that they would let them pass through. And even if she couldn't speak the language, just the fact that they had her with them, and not in a sense of where she was a captive or a prisoner, you know, she was there with them and in a good way, you know, wanted to be there with them, that they recognized, okay, this is not a group of people that we have to worry about. They're not going to try to attack us or things like that. And so that helped, and she especially helped them to be able to travel through the western United States and not have to worry so much with Indian attacks and any sort of negativity that would happen because of that. Now, as I mentioned, it took them a little bit over 2 years to make the trip. So, you know, they were gone quite a long time. And as you see here in this picture, it kind of gives you an idea of some of the things they're, you know, dealing with coming up the river, trying to bring their people and supplies and try to go as far as they could on the river. But again, once the river stopped, they had to abandon their boats and they had to hike, and, you know, they're walking by foot because they don't have horses with them. And so this was really a you know, a long, long journey for them. And thankfully, they took journals with them and they wrote down everything that they were encountering. And that was kind of the job that Thomas Jefferson gave them, was to, you know, document everything. Let us know exactly what's out there. So when they do return, they're basically national heroes. Their people are amazed by these journeys. They want to hear all the stories, and they have some amazing stories to tell. And just remember, this is a time we're talking about when there's not pro sports, there's not movies, there's not television, there's not celebrities like we have it today. So, you know, your celebrities of those days are going to be your military leaders and your explorers and your politicians for the most part. And so these guys were just incredible heroes when they returned, because they had done things other people had never done and shown a lot of bravery in doing it. Now, some of the things for you to do for the remainder of the class, we have a video that we want you to watch, and as you watch the video, you're going to take 5 notes describing things Lewis and Clark experienced on their journey. So we'll tell you some different things. Just jot those down. You can do this in Word, probably what I'd recommend, but you could do it on paper if you'd like, but probably prefer it that you do it on Word. Make sure you save it to your directory. Once you're done with the video, there's a link for a journal, and we want you to go to this website and you can actually read what Lewis and Clark wrote. So I want you to click on at least five different entries. You can do more, but click on at least 5 different entries, and then on that same sheet of paper, write down what you learned. What was it that they talk about in their different entries? And then the last part that you're going to be doing with Lewis and Clark, we think you'll really enjoy. There's a link to go to a National Geographic site where you are going to be Lewis and Clark, in essence, and you're going to take this journey, and you will make decisions about what to do for, you know, what are you going to take in certain situations, how are you going to respond, you know, if Native Americans are seeming like they might be hostile or things of that nature. It's real important while you're doing this journey, you're going to have some options to, like, read a journal entry or find out more. It's real important that you click on those buttons. Don't just rush through, you know, making your choices of I'm going to do this or that. If you see little circles, as if, you know, there's some circles up here, if you see those kinds of things, make sure you click on them and read them, because they're going to give you some valuable information and maybe some things that you might see on the test later on. The final thing that you'll be doing is you are going to write your own journal entry. So you're going to pretend that you are either Lewis, Clark, part of the crew that's traveling with them, or Sacagawea. And what you will do is you're going to come up with a scenario based off what you've learned that potentially could have happened. And so, you know, we don't want anything that's outrageous. You know, we don't write something about, well, aliens came today and we battled Martians all day long. You know, it needs to be something realistic. And so what you need to do is put yourself in the place of one of those people. Pretend that you're there, and then document in your journal what it is that you encounter. Your journal entry should have the date, so come up with a date that would be appropriate for that time, a location of where you are, and it doesn't have to be a specific, you know, for instance, you can say we are, you know, in the Rocky Mountains, or we are traveling along the Missouri River, you know, something of that regard. It doesn't have to be very specific as far as a, you know, we're in St. Louis on 2nd Avenue type of thing. And so what you're going to do is put yourself in that situation, think of, or as that person, think of a situation, and then write down in your journal, document, you know, what happened. What was the issue? Was there anything leading up to the issue? How did you handle it? How did everyone respond to the way that was handled? And so make it kind of inclusive of, it should be kind of read a little bit like a story. So we are looking for several sentences, you know, a couple paragraphs perhaps, and we want to see, you know, something very detailed with what's going on. Because remember, you've been hired by Thomas Jefferson to really detail your journey across the Louisiana Territory and out to the Pacific Ocean. So we need to know the details of what you're encountering. So make sure that you are very detailed when you write this. This should could also be on that same sheet of paper. That's perfectly fine. And you will submit this through Blackboard for a grade. So make sure that you are saving this to your directory. Make sure you've saved it with your name. And then we'll have you submit it through Blackboard, and that'll get you another grade in the gradebook. So that pretty much covers it for Lewis and Clark, what we're doing today. If you have any questions, as always, don't hesitate to ask, and I'll be happy to help you as I can. Good luck.